Derek has already introduced the LoRaWAN certification program. That's why I will focus my talk on the LCTT pretesting tool, which could be really helpful for you if you are planning to prepare your product for the official LoRaWAN certification. Here I will explain you what the LCTT is and how you could get it. Additionally, you will see a demo showing how to connect it to the IMSD Lite Gateway and how to get it running on your PC. To prepare the end device for the LoRaWAN certification, it is important that additional to the standard LoRaWAN application, the end device follows the end device certification requirement document. This provides the description of a test application required on the end device to be able to run all test cases defined within the LoRaWAN certification. Additionally, you should configure your product to be automatically LoRaWAN activated after powering it up to be able to run the whole test. Going into detail on the end device certification requirements, the end device should include a test application running on port 224. In this case, you should ensure that you are following the correct document as the test application has been modified for the update of the LoRaWAN certification for version 1.0.4. This means that if you are preparing your end device for version 1.0.2, you should provide a test mode implementation. This includes several test commands for its control, such as the test mode activation, deactivation, echo command, and selection of confirmed or unconfirmed uplinks. Once the test mode is activated, the end device must stop its standard application and disable the duty cycle restrictions. Afterwards, it is expected that the device sends periodic uplinks as quickly as possible, for example every 5 seconds. On the other hand, with the update of the LoRaWAN certification to version 1.0.4, it was decided to run the test cases as often as possible using the standard application of each end device. This ensures its correct behavior also in its normal operation in field. The main difference is that most of the test cases will be run following the duty cycle restrictions, and therefore the test harness will configure the end device if possible with the maximum allowed data rate to decrease the testing time. Nevertheless, some test commands on port 224 are still required to control the end device during the test, such as selection of confirmed or unconfirmed uplinks, echo command, or configuration of the duty cycle restrictions. But a remarkable change included in this version is that the access to the test port is expected to be enabled only for the duration of the certification tests. This application must be disabled on any device in production, otherwise it may be intentionally or accidentally activated to harm the device itself or the network in its radio coverage. Thanks to those requirements, the test harness can run all tests to ensure the correct LoRaWAN behavior. Once you have finished the design of your product, if you are interested in getting it through the LoRaWAN certification process, the LCTT pretesting tool may be an interesting option for you. The LCTT is a pretesting tool developed by the LoRa Alliance to allow an easier pretesting of the devices before sending them for the formal LoRaWAN certification. Using this, the device manufacturers can save time and money helping them to debug and finalize the design of their product. Everything you need to run the LCTT tool is a PC, LoRaWAN gateway and your end device. And of course, if you have interest on trying it, you should contact the LoRa Alliance. This tool is available under the members portal and you will get one free license. The latest update of the LCTT includes the possibility to test the LoRaWAN version 1.0.4. At this point, it's important to remark the main differences between running the LCTT as pretesting tool and the official LoRaWAN certification. While the official certification requires a 16 or 64 channels gateway, depending on the number of channels defined for the LoRaWAN region to be certified, the LCTT could be used as a pretesting tool using a standard 8-channel gateway. In this case, if you are testing a dynamic channel plan such as Europe, India, Asia or Russia, the main difference comes up while trying to add multiple channels. Here the official certification will make use of 16 different frequency values, while in the LCTT some frequency values will be repeated in some channel IDs. The fixed channel plan includes North America and Australia. In this particular situation, some test cases had to be modified or even removed if an 8-channel gateway is connected. This is because some of the uplinks would be missed by the LCTD and the correct behavior of the device under test could not be verified. This will be automatically decided by the LCTD depending on the gateway's model configured. Once you have your end device ready and the LCTD tool installed on your computer, you should configure the LoRaWAN gateway. If you choose our IMST Lite gateway, we will recommend you to follow the quick start guide. Basically, everything you need is to power it up, connect the gateway to your computer with an Ethernet cable and access to it via SSH for its configuration. You will need to run the LoRa packet forwarder available on GitHub and also pre-installed on the gateway image, and the settings in the global config file should be modified for your setup. As server address, you should enter the IP address of the computer where the LCTD is running. And remember the server UDP ports configured here because you should enter the same values in the LCTD. Finally, you should configure the different reception channels on the gateway. These will be based on the two center frequencies and 8 different channels with bandwidth 125, one additional channel on bandwidth 250, for example for SF7, and one additional channel for FSK can be configured. These settings must include at least the default channels for the selected region as defined in the regional parameters document. In this demo, I will show a test run for Europe. Now you only need to run the packet forwarder application and configure the LCTD tool as follows. If this is the first time you run the LCTD tool, you should upgrade the license for each technology package installed. You will get the license file after sending the file generated by request license file to the LoRa Alliance. Then we will start creating a new project. The first step after loading this project is to assign a device. I will create a new DUT and add a sample to it. We will assign this DUT to the project. Now we should configure all the required parameters. Under DUT Setup Editor, we will select the LoRaWAN region and continue the setting in the Europe tab. We should choose the corresponding LoRaWAN version, select the Class A option and select the supported features. Note that some of these options are not applicable for version 1.0.4 as these are not optional features. Under DUT Extra Setup Editor, we go to the Europe tab and enter the DUT activation parameters. We will use the over-the-air activation and therefore we will skip the first three parameters for activation by personalization. We will start configuring the application EUI and the max and minimum transmission power. Then we need to enter the address to be assigned after the activation and the application key and the device EUI. Under the General Parameters Editor, the default parameters for each region are specified. Here it is important to configure the gateway information correctly. IP address, model and ports used for the communication with the gateway. Additionally, the IP address corresponding to the computer where the LCTD is running should be introduced as network server IP address. Under the test cases option, the test cases to be run should be selected. Here, all applicable test cases should be selected if you want to run the complete LoRaWAN certification. But for this demo, we will run only the test case related to the MAC commands that tried to modify the parameters of the RX windows. As you can see, some test cases require some input parameters which you could adjust for your setup. Now we have everything ready to start our test. The first pool data ensures that the communication with the gateway works properly and the end device can start with the over-the-air activation procedure. All LoRaWAN messages sent by the DUT and LCTD will be shown in the trace window. The LCTD will enable the test mode on the end device after its successful activation and will make use of the test mode commands to run all selected test cases sequentially. Finally, the test mode will be deactivated. You will be able to see the result for each test case after their completion. Once the test has finished, you will have access to the detailed log file. This will include a report with the final result and some additional parameters related to the LCTT version that has been used. Here you could also find the content of all LoRaWAN messages exchanges, including the radiation parameters used, like frequency and data rate. This will help you to understand and analyze your issues if you find some. Finally, the LCTT offers a release and a debug. The first one does not allow to run the test cases if the original files have been modified. On the other side, the debug mode includes a packet sniffer and allows you to run your own test cases. Besides the LoRaWAN certification, additional testing may be interesting for you. Here I will show you an overview of some of them. First of all, if your product is based on an already LoRaWAN certified module, you may request a LoRaWAN certification by similarity, which simplifies the LoRaWAN certification process. Additionally, the radiation performance testing will provide a full radiated power and a sensitivity figure of the devices. For this, you should also contact to a LoRa Alliance authorized test house, which will give you more information about this. And don't forget that the regulatory testing is not part of the LoRaWAN certification process. This approval is required if you would like to release a new product to market. This can take place before, after, or at the same time with the LoRaWAN certification testing.